Transport Group Piston believes the exemptions set by government after the lapse of the consolidation deadline may have stirred confusion among jeepney drivers. A memorandum by the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board last week said that traditional jeepneys which fail to consolidate their franchises will still be allowed until January 31, 2024 to ply routes where less than 60% of units are consolidated. Piston says no route has reached the 60% mark yet, which means they can technically still operate.
Ito nga po yung isang nakakalito na inilabas nga ng LTFRB na nagbigay nga ng isang buwan. At sinasabi nga nila na pwede pa tayong bumiyahe sa loob ng isang buwan. Pero ang sinasabi naman ng LTFRB din, sabi nila hindi na pwedeng bumiyahe dahil expired na nga yung wala na nga tayong prangkisa o wala ng PA. Kaya nagdudulot ito ng kalitukan sa hanay ng ating transport sector. Bibiyahe ba kami ng January 1 o hindi na kami bibiyahe ng January 1? Pero sa atin ay batay po doon sa inlabas nga ng LTFRB. Sabi natin, bumiyahe tayo dahil nagbigay naman na extended ng isang buwan ng LTFRB. At kung ano may yung kalituan, hindi tayo yung may problema. May problema rin yung LTFRB dahil hindi malinaw yung kanilang inilabas.
Another transport group opposed to the consolidation is hoping that the extension period will also give authorities additional time to reconsider the policy.
Malaking bagay po ito sa amin, kagaya po nung nasabi namin nung mga nakaraan na malaking bagay po ito at pinagpapasalamat pa rin po namin. Kahit isang buwan lang ito, alam namin na marami pang pwedeng mangyari na baka sakali mapagbigyan tayo, pinggan pa rin po tayo, lalo na po ang Korte Suprema na lagi po natin ipinagdadasal na sana ay magkaroon na po ng TRO at mapag-aralan po itong muli.
The deadline for the government's controversial PUV consolidation comes to an end with Filipino commuters bracing for its impact. Despite massive protests, the transport authorities stuck with the December 31st deadline for the jeepney franchise consolidation. The Transportation Department looking pleased with the results, saying major routes in Metro Manila are now being operated by consolidated groups. But other transport groups reject government's claims.
Kapag hindi na talaga tayo pinayagan na makapag-renew ng ating prangkisa, ay talagang dito natin daranasin yung sinasabi natin transport crisis.
Meanwhile, unconsolidated drivers are still allowed to ply select routes until the end of January, but they can no longer join a cooperative. The number of firecracker-related injuries in the Philippines climbs to 231 as Filipinos rang in the new year. Let's get more details from our correspondent, Adrian Ayalin, who now joins us today. Adrian, 231, that doesn't sound so good.
Yes, it doesn't sound so good, but according to Department of Health Secretary Herbosa, the fireworks-related injuries this year may have increased compared to last year, but the multi-agency information campaign of the government against illegal firecrackers still worked. As for an assessment, Herbosa noted that the campaign was satisfactory. Herbosa stressed that this year is the first year that the public health emergency status on COVID-19 was lifted, as the past years of the pandemic saw limited public gatherings, which, of course, resulted to lesser number of injuries. Herbosa noted that from 6 a.m. of December 21, 2023, up to 5:59 a.m. of January 1, 2024, 116 new cases of fireworks-related injuries were registered. Herbosa reported that for this year, the total injuries is at 231, with 49% of the cases, or 113, coming from the National Capital Region. 12% of the cases, or 27, came from Central Luzon, 10%, or 10, from Ilocos Region, while those with the lowest number of cases are Davao Region, Mimaropa, Northern Mindanao, Central Visayas, and the Cordillera Autonomous Region. Herbosa also reiterated that law enforcement agencies, particularly the Philippine National Police and local government units, should also step up their efforts as illegal firecrackers were apparently readily available to the public. Herbosa noted that among the top 9 firecrackers that caused injuries were 5-star Boga, Piccolo, and Plaplau, which are considered illegal fireworks. The DOH also reported that the ages of the victims ranged from 11 months to 76 years old, with the median age at 20 years old. The 11-month-old baby from the National Capital Region got burns because of a piccolo lit by someone else on the street. The 76-year-old male from Ilocos Region was injured in the eye by a quitis, which he himself lit inside his home. There were also 5 cases of stray bullet victims, while there are 3 new amputation cases, which totaled to 11. No reports of ingestion so far, but the DOH said they will continue to monitor the situation for all injuries, as other victims may have not yet gone to hospitals. Meantime, asked about the apparent air pollution, at least here in Metro Manila, caused by firecrackers, Herbosa stressed the need for designated fireworks display in isolated areas such as Manila Bay. Back to you, Stanley.
All right, Adrian. As you mentioned, we are coming from a low base considering there was little firecracker usage during the pandemic years. And today, you have this number of 231, which the DOH is saying it's good enough, all things considered. When do they stop counting?
He mentioned that they will up to January 6 or so, that they will still be monitoring the injuries caused by firecrackers, or at least firecracker-related injuries up to January 6. Because, again, some of the victims may have not yet gone to hospitals. Herbosa also particularly noted or advised the public for in case they have not yet gone to hospitals but they have injuries. He warned against tetanus. He said that injuries should be cleaned, and if needed, these victims may need vaccines against tetanus. Stanley?
All right. On that note, we thank you so much for joining us this afternoon, Adrian, Aileen. Happy New Year to you. Stay safe. The Philippine Health Department reports 231 fireworks-related injuries. 116 came in the wake of the recently concluded New Year festivities, the first since lockdown restrictions were totally eased, and the first as well since the COVID-19 state of emergency was lifted globally. Around 49% or 113 of the total cases came from Metro Manila, followed by Central Luzon and the Ilocos region.
Ito ang una nating New Year na lift na yung tinatawag na public health emergency. So naalala nyo, nung time na COVID, community display lang ang allowed at bawal magpaputok ang ating mga kababayan. So for this time, nag-umpisa na naman magpaputok at nakita naman natin na tumaas ng kaunti ng ating fireworks-related injuries. Ngayon naman, ang babantayan ng Department of Health ay yung cases ng tetanus. So paalala natin sa lahat ng mga na-injure, kahit maliit po, pumunta kayo sa emergency department para malinis ang sugat at mabigyan kayo ng booster shot ng tetanus vaccine.
The Bureau of Fire Protection records 0 fire incidents related to firecrackers during the holiday season. This is an improvement from the 24 blazes due to firecrackers recorded in the same period last year. But the BFB notes the leading cause of fire this holiday season is neglected or faulty electrical lines.
Masasabi din po talaga natin na may negligence na po on the part ng mga may-ari ng residentials at ito po mga ibang location na experience nating insidente. At yun nga po ang ating paulit-ulit na paalala ay magkaroon po tayo ng regular checking ng ating linya ng mga kuryente. Intensified po ang ating fire safety inspection sa mga establishments. Ano? However, dahil nga po majority nitong incidents natin ay residential, hindi po kasi siya sakop ng ating fire code.
Meanwhile, a fire gutted 2 warehouses in Malabon City on Monday. The fire broke out at around 1 in the morning and was declared under control after 4 hours. No one was hurt in the incident. Initial investigation shows the fire originated from a warehouse of online shopping parcels.